waking up Eastern Carolina and the world. You're listening to the number one morning show with North Carolina Broadcasters Hall of Fame host, Henry Hinton. Listen on air or online at WTIBFM.com. This is Talk of the Town.
Okay, welcome back. Talk of the Town here on Tuesday morning, June the 12th. We are one day away from our big concert on the Common. I was just down the hall discussing it with Mark Paschal, who's going to be helping the band tomorrow night. The band that has been named by Axis TV as the number one Eagles tribute band in the country. And I can tell you from having seen this band before, you want to get there early. The show will start, the gates will open at like 5 o'clock. Show will start a little bit after 5 o'clock, but get there and get your lounge chair set up. The Coastal Beverage Company will be there. They're going to be Miller Lights available, so you can have a brew while you're sitting there waiting. Should I say bring an umbrella? I mean, it's a 30% chance.
I think you'd probably be okay
to bring an umbrella.
I did yesterday.
I'll just check the radar tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah. I mean, it's 30% chance, of scattered showers. You know, there could be a little pop-up storm, but if it is, it's going to kind of move through, so I'm not that worried about it. So everybody show up tomorrow. I've seen this band perform before, and they kind of take you through the various waves of the Eagles. So they start at the beginning. So if you want to hear some of the early 70s stuff, like Take It Easy or Peaceful Easy Feeling, and I would say get there early. I mean, now I could be wrong. They may have changed up the show since I saw it 2 years ago. But this is worth it. If you like the Eagles, you're going to love this. This is a really good band. They are Axis TV voted them the number one Eagles tribute band in the country. And we'll have them tomorrow night, 5 to 8, free concert on the Town Common. Thank our sponsors. A lot of our sponsors will have tents out there tomorrow night. Go up to them and say thanks for sponsoring it, which makes it free for you to attend. All you got to do is bring your lounge chair, and you'll be good to go. Thanks to Greenville Toyota, Vidant Health, Keller Williams Points East Real Estate, Bojangles, Polly Pilon State Farm Insurance, and Suddenlink. So, come on out and stop by the sponsor booths and say, if nothing else, just stop and say, hey, thanks for sponsoring this, which makes it free for the community, because this is not a cheap band we're having tomorrow night. Not a cheap band. These guys are good. And not that any of them are cheap, but let's just say they're a lot more expensive than the Embers. So we did a big crowd out there tomorrow night. Come on out, everybody, and enjoy yourself. We're doing it for the community, and our sponsors have stepped up to really help you. 5 to 8 tomorrow night. McGee, you coming?
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Holding you to it.
Yes.
Heather?
I will be there.
Heather? She'll be at the pool.
I will not be at the pool.
Heather's kind of on the border.
She's
ba-dum-ching. We'll have to see. I mean, 5 o'clock, my little kids.
It's tough for little kids.
It's a risky time of day for us.
Bring them. There's going to be face painting for the kids tomorrow night.
Okay.
There's going to be superheroes.
Heard.
Deadpool. I understand Captain America
heard.
And
Deadpool.
And Deadpool.
That makes me laugh so hard.
We've already seen the Deadpool costume, and it's pretty good.
It's good.
Yeah, parts of it had to be a little altered. When I first saw it, I went, no, you got to fix that.
Rightfully so.
It was a little tight. So we're having Deadpool fix his costume, but he's going to show up. All right, so that's tomorrow night. Come on out and enjoy Concert on the Common, part two. And it's the second of three. We're only doing three this year. We're doing this as kind of a test to see how well they do. The Ember Show went really well, so we hope to have you out tomorrow night for our Concert on the Common, brought to you by Interbanks Media and the Uptown Greenville Association in association with the City of Greenville. I'd like to say thanks to Ann Wall and the Parks and Recreation, Gary Fenton, guys at Parks and Rec. The police chief, everybody's been very cooperative in trying to bring this new deal to Greenville. So come on out and enjoy tomorrow night. All right. I found this very interesting this morning. We've been talking about North Korea and politics and stuff. Here's something more interesting. You know, do you ever see somebody who you think you look at that person and go, man, that person really has their life together? You know, I don't see many of them anymore. I used to see more than I do now. But, I mean, do you? Can you think of somebody when I say that? Man, that person really has their life together. Now, you don't know what's going on behind the scenes, but I can think of a few people, you know. I can think of a few people where I'm like, oh, man, they really got their life together. So there's a study out that says that you can actually name the signs that someone has their life together. What do you think they are?
Hmm.
You want me to go through them for you?
Yeah.
Some of them are kind of funny, but I mean, they're probably true. Number 10, smelling good. So somebody's, you know, I mean, I can buy into that.
Yeah.
If you're smelly, you don't have your life together.
That leaves me out.
Actually, that's correct. Number 9, keeping eye contact when they're having conversations.
How about that?
No, yeah. I try and do that.
You know how you talk to somebody and you know that they're not confident because they keep looking down or they look, you know. I'm not going to say who it is, but I know somebody that when you talk to them, they start looking off to the left. When they're talking, they look off to the left.
Hmm.
So eye contact during chats, conversations, that's very important. If you want to fake people into believing that you have your act together. Number 8, wearing nice clothes. So far, Heather's making this list in a big way.
Well, thanks.
I would put Heather on this list, wouldn't you, McGee?
I would. Yeah. Heather, you have your life together. You really do.
Number 7 is owning a car. I mean, that's kind of rudimentary in today's environment, but I guess it would be necessary to own a car to have your act together.
0 for 4.
Number 6 is eating healthy. Okay, now I got to tell you that I'm on a new kick about eating healthy because my wife's making me. No, I'm just kidding. I even got up this morning. I just had Raisin Bran for breakfast. I'm going to start eating more healthy. I read something over the weekend about things you can do when you get to in your older years, like I'm getting into, to kind of keep yourself together. And one of them is eating healthy, and so I'm going to start eating healthy. I started right after the pizza last night.
There you go.
Number 5, again, this is a list of from a survey of people who have their lives together. I don't know. Some people are not going to like this one. You're married.
Oh.
Now, there are some people who think that they're more together because they're not married, right? So 37%.
I've never thought that.
Yeah. I don't know. Number 4, having a good and pretty high-paying job. Well, of course.
Well, yeah, I thought that.
That's an easy one.
Hmm.
Number 3, keeping up a regular exercise routine. Number 2, you follow through on plans that you make. So, boy, man, do I see that a lot in business. You hear about these great plans, but people don't follow through. And the number 1 sign that someone has their life together, 50% of the people surveyed said that they own a home. Owning a home means you got your life together. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I buy that.
Yeah, I wouldn't buy that one either.
I don't know about the good and high-paying job. I mean, when I think about a friend of mine who really has her life together, she's a stay-at-home mom, and she's...
Right.
I mean...
And there's nothing in there about people's spirituality.
Nothing
which I,
at all.
Which I thought was kind of interesting. This list probably came from the left coast, where there is no spirituality, where people are godless for the most part. Well, not everyone, but a lot of people are. Holly Weird. Okay.
Go ahead,
send those emails right now to Heather King.
Hey, now.
No, I mean to Trent McGee. To Trent McGee.
Send all email to Trent McGee.
Oh, man. All right. Here's another list that I thought would be fun to talk about this morning. Rolling Stone has put together a list of the 50 greatest comedies of the 21st century.
Nice.
Can you think of some of these I think are stupid, But some of them are pretty funny. My wife is going to look at all of these and go, oh, my God, and I don't like any of them. I'll run through them real fast. Starting at number 20, the Great Budapest Hotel, which is just 2 years ago. I didn't see that. Number 19 is Mean Girls.
Oh, my gosh,
which has just been turned into a Broadway show.
Hilarious movie.
Is it really?
It is. Never hilarious.
It. Number 18, Tropical Thunder. I'm 0 for 3. Haven't seen it, any of the three of them. Number 17, What We Do in the Shadows. Number 16, Lady Bird. Number 15, A Serious Man. Number 14, Everybody Wants Some, which was the spiritual sequel to Dazed and Confused. Number 13, The Death of Stalin. So far, I haven't seen any of these. These are supposed to be the funniest movies of the 21st century. Number 12, yes, Anchorman.
Oh, yes.
Seen it. Got one.
Number 11, In Bruges, B-R-U-G-E-S. Number 10, State and Maine. Nope. Number 9, Are You Serious? The 40-Year-Old Virgin?
I saw it.
I thought it was stupid. I didn't get it. Number 8, Shaun of the Dead.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that. I don't think it's that funny.
Number 7, Tony Erdmann, which is a German movie. Number 6, Punch Drunk Love. Number 5, Idiocracy. Number 4, Step Brothers. Dumbest movie I've ever... I didn't even watch all of that. I watched like...
There were funny parts.
That movie.
Number 2, In the Loop.
Wait, what was number 3?
I left number 3. Bridesmaids.
I didn't see that.
Number 2, the political satire In the Loop. Mm-hmm. And number 1, I guess this is since the year 2000, because there's someone here Caddyshack.
Oh, I know what it's going to be.
What is it?
Hangover.
No.
Oh.
Didn't make the list. Hmm. Best in Show.
That is a funny movie.
Is it really?
Yeah, it is.
I don't know these movies.
It's about like it's like a faux documentary about the dog show industry.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure that's what they're talking about, and it is really
funny.
Yes, it's very funny.
Well, see, when I'm in the mood, I'll go to Netflix and watch some of these.
Watch Mean Girls. I mean, that's pretty much the only thing on there, and that is Tina Fey wrote it and stars in it, and it is really it's Lindsay Lohan and at her finest. Really
doesn't sound like my kind of thing.
Probably not, but it is. Hey, it's my kind of thing, and I'll own that.
Doesn't sound like my kind of thing, but Heather, you and my wife can watch that.
That sounds like a deal.
You know the funniest movie in my opinion of all time is Office Space.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
That must have been before 2000, though.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's way before.
It was on the other night, and I watched it again. I mean, it's like a car wreck when it's on. You have to watch.
I like my stapler back. Yeah.
Milton and the stapler.
It is so funny.
What's that guy, Gary, the guy that plays the boss? He plays, he walks around with his coffee cup and goes, yeah, McGee, I'm going to have to ask you to come in on Saturday.
I love the neighbor of that with, their paper-thin apartment walls.
Oh, yeah. The guy's listening to every conversation through the walls. There's so many gags in that movie.
Oh,
yeah.
It's so
good.
If you
haven't seen that, you got to watch it.
The gag with the stapler, the gag with the copier.
Yeah. Oh.
They hate the office copier. They take it out and shoot it in a field.
Scenes in all time.
You know, it's like everybody's always wanted to, at some point, take the office copier out into a cornfield and shoot it.
Absolutely.
So they do it in this movie.
Chris got me a new printer at our house for Christmas, and he printed out a picture of the guys beating the copier up, and he's like, here you go, you're getting a new printer. I'm like, yeah!
1999 is
what I just missed it. That's got to be the
funny. I thought it was before then.
I did, too. That's a great movie.
And, you know, Caddyshack, you'd have to put Caddyshack in there.
Caddyshack's
in the 80s. But, I've seen Caddyshack so many times now. It's beyond funny now. It's kind of part of my DNA because I can kind of sit there and quote the lines like the Rocky Horror Picture Show. Like the people who used to go to the Rocky Horror Picture Show and sit in the movie and recite the lines while they were being said on the screen.
Office Space kind of put Jennifer Aniston on the map.
It did?
Didn't it?
Yeah.
Didn't it?
I thought she was already on the map.
She already had Friends, I think.
Was it Friends
that?
Before 99?
I mean, movies, acting,
maybe
right?
Maybe in movies.
Yeah,
movies.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, maybe not. I don't know.
She was great in that movie,
I just wanted
too.
To see.
She was good at that
I really like to talk about my flair.
My flair, right. If you haven't seen the movie, you don't understand it. If you have, you know it's funny. You know it's funny. All right, 20 minutes after 8 o'clock, Talk of the Town, here on Tuesday morning, a rare Heather King appearance in the studio this morning. Heather will check the news headlines next.
It's the Mission Greenville Toyota Summer Event. Buy Corollas $14,999 or lease for $99 a month. RAV4s $20,995 or $149 a month at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't, so people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
This is the Pepsi that gets you stuff. Like tickets to...
Who doesn't love Pepsi stuff? Drink Pepsi, get stuff.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't, so people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Let us help you find the right car or truck this spring here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Take advantage of May lease specials on all new Jeeps during the Jeep Celebration event. Lease the new 2019 Jeep Cherokee for only $199 a month. Lease the all-new 2018 Wrangler JL for just $239 a month. Or lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $269 a month.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
One name, 300 vehicles. The Mission Greenville Toyota Summer Event starts now. Buy Camrys, $17,995, or lease for $129 a month at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
With the information you need to start your day, this is your news update on 103.7 WTIB and 94.1 WNBU.
Good morning with your WITN News Update. I'm Heather King. Investigators say a fire that killed two people and injured three others was started by a toddler playing with a lighter. It happened on Beulahtown Road in Kenley Saturday morning. Johnson County deputies say they found David Creech and his two-year-old son Matthew dead inside the home. The girlfriend of David Creech and both his three-year-old and 10-year-old sons were transported to UNC Chapel Hill. They're listed in serious but stable condition. Investigators say the fire started in a toddler's bed because a juvenile was playing with a lighter. They say no criminal activity is believed to have occurred, but an investigation is ongoing. President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un have signed a joint document in which they commit to working toward a complete denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula. The document signed by the leaders at their historic summit says they will also join efforts to build a lasting and stable peace regime on the peninsula. The document lays out four broad commitments. It says the sides commit to establish new U.S.-DPRK relations in accordance with the desire and peoples of in the two countries for peace and prosperity. And it says they will commit to recovering the remains of prisoners of war and those missing in action. A camper was destroyed and two others damaged when strong storms rolled through parts of eastern Carolina Monday. The worst damage happened at the Eagle's Nest Campground on Highway 102 outside of Chocowinity. No one was hurt in the demolished camper. The dog, who was inside at the time, returned home several hours later, unhurt. Beaufort County officials say they're checking with the National Weather Service to see if the damage was a tornado or because of strong winds. A Jacksonville police officer has been put on desk duty after firing his weapon. Corporal Christopher Wilson is on administrative leave for firing his gun at a person who made a threatening move, officials say, with a gun at the officers. This happened at the Champagne Lounge inside the Red Carpet Inn on North Marine Boulevard in Jacksonville around 1 in the morning Monday, where a fight was underway. Police call what was going on at the lounge a major disturbance. Police say they found the man's weapon, but they're still searching for him. They do not believe that he was shot. Deputies say the driver of a vehicle that struck and killed a wild horse along the Outer Banks will not be charged. The Currituck County Sheriff's Office says it happened around 10:30 p.m. Saturday in Corolla. Deputies say a driver from Virginia Beach was heading north when 4 to 5 horses ran from the dunes towards the water. One of the horses was hit and killed by the front tire. The driver told authorities they were going about 20 to 25 miles per hour at the time and that conditions were foggy with low visibility. Those are your WITN News headlines. I'm Heather King.
Mostly cloudy skies, for today with a few showers around in the morning. Scattered showers and a few storms by the afternoon with highs in the upper 70s. For tonight, we'll see showers decreasing after sunset with lows in the low 70s. For your Wednesday, partly cloudy skies with a 30%, you know what, no chance of rain. That's my forecast. For no chance of rain for throughout the entire day. Going to be plenty of sunshine and great for concert on the common. Lows tomorrow night will be right around 74 degrees. Take that one.
Yeah.
Take that.
News and Weather, a service of Acre Station Meat Farm, which is located just between Washington and Plymouth on Highway 32. And it is absolutely the best time of year to visit Acre Station.
Is it really going on?
What?
The sale?
It's the combo sale.
Okay.
The combo sale. Which, by the way, is some of the best pricing of the year because they have the combination where you can go down there and stock up the freezer. The combos go anywhere from $64.99 to $265, and the combos include everything, including steaks, extra lean ground beef, more of their famous Acre Station link sausage, bacon. We had some of that bacon over the weekend. Unbelievable!
So good.
We have it all in the but I'm going back during the combo sale. Combo sale is only going to last a few more days, so check out the website acrestation.com. Click in for in-store freezer specials. Again, the combo prices go. The combos start as low as $64.99 and go to $265. It's definitely worth the drive to buy your meat at Acre Station on Highway 32 between Washington and Green. You want to ride together?
Sure.
Yeah.
I mean, if you want to
take the Cooler.
We'll take the minivan. You can ride shotgun with my kids in the back. Uncle Henry.
Here, kid, play with your iPad.
Yeah.
That's what you got to do on those road trips.
Long enough.
Isn't that terrible? You know, you're always, listen, be quiet. You put your turn your iPad on and play with your, and then when you get home, you're like, why you got that iPad on? Get out there and play outside in the sunshine.
Go cut the grass.
Right. You're 8.
Acre Station's open Monday through Saturday, 6:30 to 4:30. Come out to Acre Station and get some of the best sausage and bacon you'll ever eat. I guarantee it. I am personally putting my guarantee on at Acre Station. 29 after 8, Heather is leaving us to go be mom again.
Actually, no, I'm going to the studio. I'm anchoring WITN News at noon today.
Oh, 12 o'clock today. All right, nice. All right, little Joe Walsh. By the way, you'll hear this tomorrow night. The band will play all the Joe Walsh stuff as well as the Eagles hits. And the guy that does the Joe Walsh songs is awesome. He can play this one right here. Crank it up a little bit, Mike.
Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is the truck dealer in Eastern North Carolina. We are overloaded with new Ram trucks, and we've discounted every one of them to move.
Folks from all over Eastern North Carolina are heading to Washington to save on new Ram trucks. Get up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks right now.
Visit us at WashingtonChrysler.com. Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Drive a little to save a lot.
This is the Pepsi that gets you stuff. Like tickets to...
Who doesn't love Pepsi stuff? Drink Pepsi, get stuff.
Let us help you find the right car or truck this spring here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
See ya. Bye, see ya.
Right now, you can get up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks. That's up to $12,000 off a new 2018 Ram in May. You can't beat this deal on a new truck. Hurry in before they're all gone.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Let's see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't, so people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Carolina's greatest hits play all day on 107.9 WNCT.
Don't stop believing. Oh, give it all a prayer.
All your favorites.
Just like the ocean,
with Mark, Mark, and Laura in the morning. Carolina's greatest hits play here.
WNCT.
Okay, coming up this weekend in up in Gates County, it's going to be more of the great water ski competition that we've seen at Beaver Lake. It's the Beaver Lake Pro-Am and Night Jump. It's back for 2018. Here to talk about that is the man that puts it all together up there and brings all this great water ski competition to Eastern North Carolina, my buddy Jeff Mitchell. Good morning, Jeff. How are you?
Good morning, Henry. I'm doing great. I hope you are.
Every year you outdo yourself. This is some of the top water ski competition in the country, and it takes place right here in Eastern North Carolina up near Ahoskie at Beaver Lake. And we'll give directions on how to get there. But tell us, I guess things will start on Saturday, and you got a night jump Saturday this time. Is that right?
Yes. So the layout for Saturday and Sunday – It's really an event within an event, Henry, because all day Saturday and Sunday there'll be a fully sanctioned world record capability slalom and jump tournament going on Saturday and Sunday. And Saturday we'll do the first round of slalom in the morning, and then we'll do the two rounds of jump under the sanctioned tournament. And then the top eight jumpers from the jump event that afternoon will advance and be eligible to compete in the night jump that will take a 2-hour break, and we'll start back up at 7 p.m. and those top eight will go out there for cash prizes. So we'll come out with a field of eight, and then we'll cut to four, and then we'll cut to the finals of two.
I don't, you know, I've been to Beaver Lake. I've seen it. It's a beautiful little facility. If people have never seen Beaver Lake, it's perfect. It's actually been built for water skiing, and it is absolutely perfect. And but I've never seen it with the lights. So you bring in portable lights out there? Is that how you do it? That's got to be beautiful at night.
Yeah, we do. It really is cool looking. Go on our Facebook page, and you'll see some pictures of it. It doesn't do it justice for being out there perfect. It's almost a little bit eerie at night, especially when there's a little fog on the water. It's kind of a cool atmosphere for this kind of event. But we've got, portable lights we bring in. And then we mounted permanent stadium lights over the jump landing area just because that's where the crowd sits, and we didn't want the noise and heat of the mechanical engines running the lights.
Gotcha. All right, so is there a charge for people to come in?
No, it's free admission. And both days, Gates County High School boosters will be selling food and beverages for lunch. And Saturday night at the night jump event, the Gates County EMS will be selling food service there and beverages as well for the crowd. So, you know, we love including pulling in these local nonprofits to, you know, give them an opportunity to raise money in the community too.
I'm looking at your Facebook page right now, and you're right. The pictures of the night jump are very cool there. But I'm looking at are there homes on the lake now? I see a home back there.
Yeah, there are. There's three cabins back there right now, and three of the owners of the property have built weekend places in the back.
No
of the
kidding.
Back of the property.
No yep. kidding. Lucky yep. them. What a great spot.
Absolutely.
What a great spot. All right. Tell us about the skiers. Where do the skiers come from? I know you've had some of the top ski competitors in the country come for this event every year.
Yeah, we have. And, you know, with this night jump event, and one thing that we do is, you know, we this gives an opportunity for the up-and-coming pros that have their target set on the Masters and Moomba and these other worldwide events to get an opportunity to participate in a night jump event. So it's some years it's like Forrest Gump in a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. but we've got among other ones, we've got Tara Grant. This is going to be cool. Tara Grant actually jumped in the women's jump division at the U.S. Masters a couple of weeks ago down at Callaway Gardens.
Wow.
And so she's a strong enough jumper that she it's because we don't have a men and women's division, Henry. But she said, that's okay. I'll take my chances on making it into the finals.
I don't need a women's division.
That's right. So she's from Canada. And her boyfriend, Harry Spavin, he's one of our top seeds from Canada. And then a couple of other guys that have never been here before, we're looking forward to having is Jacques Romain. He's from France. He was in country for a couple of tournaments the past 2 weeks, and he's going to wrap up his visit to the U.S. here at Beaver Lake and go to Norfolk and head back to across the pond Sunday night. So, Hunchio, I'm going to butcher his name, last name Yu, Korean. He's been training down at Fluid Motion outside of Orlando, and he's coming up for the event. So we've got a really diverse, entertaining, energetic young crowd. So and they love to meet the fans, and they love the fan support. So tell everybody to come out and tell the kids to bring their autographed books. They'll have a lot of fun.
All right, it's this weekend at Beaver Lake, and the easiest way to explain where Beaver Lake is, Jeff, I think, is it's just, 4 or 5 miles north of Ahoskie, is that about right, over the Chowan River Bridge?
It's about 10 miles north of Ahoskie, Henry, and about exactly two miles north of the Chowan River Bridge.
And, so you just head up like you're going up Highway 13, Highway 11, 13, is it 11 or 13?
Yes. Highway 11, and if you stay on that, you'll go right by us. And we'll have the entrance marked with safety cones and banners and such. So people should just come across Chowan River, and 2 miles up, you'll see the entrance on the right. So it's free admission. The kids can swim. So bring a bathing suit if it should be warm enough. The conditions are absolutely fantastic for great performances this weekend. We're really tickled that the rain has bounced out to give us just about the right water level. So everything's looking really good.
Are you you're not affected by the tides there, are you?
No, we're really, Henry, Beaver Lake is kind of like a well. It just kind of depends on what the groundwater's doing and how much rain we get.
Yeah, yeah. So when you get a lot of rain, that's good because the water level's high.
To a certain extent.
Yeah. You don't want too much, I guess.
There can always be too much of a good thing.
Yeah. All right. If you're interested in water skiing, some of the top water ski competitors in the world this weekend, right here in Eastern North Carolina at Beaver Lake, go to their Facebook page and look at the pictures of Beaver Lake. It is absolutely a charming little spot just north of Ahoskie. Beaver Lake is a great, it's a hidden gem, I think, in Eastern North Carolina, Jeff. And I know how hard you and others up there have worked to make it that. But this is really cool that this kind of venue exists in Eastern North Carolina to the point that you're able to get the top water ski competitors in the world to come here once a year.
Well, thank you. I'd like to, if I can, I just want to put out a great big thank you to our sponsors that have been so faithful in supporting us financially with the needs for the event. Metal Tech, Vidant Health, Nucor, Southern Insurance, the Town Bank, Roanoke Chowan News Herald, Duck Through, Commercial Ready Mix, Ahoskie Tourism Authority, Tomahawk Motel, Todd's, all these guys at Roanoke Electric had just been fantastic. Southern Bank, they've all been terrific at helping us put this together. So
my cousin Ray Felton up there at Metal Tech's been one of your biggest cheerleaders and sponsors, hadn't he?
Oh, absolutely. Ray is honorary emeritus president of Beaver Lake Ski Club. I could talk for a half hour about that guy. He's wonderful.
He's a good guy, Ray Felton up in the at Metal Tech. They do so many nice things for people up in northeastern North Carolina and down through here. I was talking to Ray one time, and he was telling me that he had put together the gate for the Pitt-Greenville Soccer Association. He had donated they built the gate and put them. I said, why would you do that? He said, just try to help kids. Ray's a good guy.
He's got a heart as big as Gates County.
Yeah. All right, Jeff Mitchell, Beaver Lake Ski Club this weekend. What's the best viewing time if somebody's going to drive in from an hour or so to come up and watch some of this? What would you suggest about the best timing to get there to see the optimum amount of activity?
If the people's schedule allows for them to be up there for the night jump, then I'd say, show up and get you a good place on the beach by 6:45, and it's going to run from like 7 to 10, and it's just going to be fun. We're going to have DJ playing and everything. It's going to be great. If the schedule doesn't allow to be out there for the evening, and it's better for them to come out during the day, they can see some fantastic jumping in the afternoon from about 2 to 5. And if you got any slalom aficionados out there, Saturday morning or all day Sunday, from Sunday from 8:30 till 4, you'll see some fantastic short line slalom and slalom course.
All right, very good. Jeff Mitchell up at Beaver Lake Ski Club. Good luck this weekend, Jeff, and thanks for being on with us.
All right, Henry, thanks for all your help. I appreciate your promotion.
Absolutely. Happy to do it. We're proud of what y'all do up there. Talk to you soon.
All right,
16 in front of 9. Let's get a break in, and we'll be back. More Talk of the Town coming up right after this.
It's the Mission Greenville Toyota Summer Event. Buy Corollas $14,999 or lease for $99 a month. RAV4s $20,995 or $149 a month at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
This is the Pepsi that gets you stuff. Like tickets to...
Who doesn't love Pepsi stuff? Drink Pepsi, get stuff.
Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamson, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Carolina's greatest hits play all day on 107.9 WNCT.
Don't stop believing. Oh, give it all a prayer.
All your favorites. With Mark and Laura in the morning. Carolina's greatest hits play here.
WNCT. Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is the truck dealer in Eastern North Carolina. We are overloaded with new Ram trucks and we've discounted every one of them to move.
Folks from all over Eastern North Carolina are heading to Washington to save on new Ram trucks. Get up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks right now.
Visit us at WashingtonChrysler.com. Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Drive a little to save a lot.
One name, 300 vehicles. The Mission Greenville Toyota Summer Event starts now. Buy Camrys, $17,995, or lease for $129 a month at Greenville Toyota, where our volume saves you money.
Talk of the Town at 8:47. We got sports coming up in a second. CNBC this morning with a story about the work of a researcher at East Carolina University. On CNBC.com this morning, the article is entitled, "The Apple Watch Just Got a Lot Better at Tracking Symptoms of Parkinson's Disease." Says the Apple Watch will soon be able to track tremors experienced by Parkinson's disease patients to help them manage their condition. Later this year, Apple will release a software update to make it easier for medical researchers to understand the difference between a random movement in the shakes and dyskinesia that Parkinson patients experience when they're getting treated with medication. The new movement disorder API will accelerate research already underway in how wearable devices can be used to track the progression of Parkinson's, said Peter Schmidt, a Parkinson's researcher and vice dean of the Brody School of Medicine at East Carolina University, who has been advising Apple's health team. About 60,000 people are diagnosed every year with Parkinson's in the U.S., not all of these patients will have access to an Apple Watch or be able to afford one, but Apple's starting to work with health insurance companies and figuring out ways to subsidize the cost. Eventually, according to Dr. Schmidt, if the results are promising, it could change how Parkinson's patients are treated as long as doctors understand how to interpret data from wearing devices. How about that? Dr. Peter Schmidt from here at the Brody School of Medicine. Being featured today on CNBC.com. Yep. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, really cool story.
Very nice. Another story that caught our eye this morning, CarolinaJournal.com, and our friend Don Carrington. Don's at it again. Let me tell you, if there's a story there, Don's going to find it, and you do not want Don Carrington investigating you. Ask Mike Easley. He's on Roy Cooper's brother again this morning. You know, there was some discussion about how the pipeline was going to run through the Cooper property. Listen to this. According to Don Carrington this morning, here are the first couple of paragraphs of the story on CarolinaJournal.com. District Court Judge Pell Cooper, Governor Roy Cooper's brother, manages three businesses, an apparent violation of state judicial rules designed to prevent conflicts of interest by judges. In 2009, state officials forced another district court judge who refused to leave two corporate boards to resign from the bench. Pell Cooper has served on the district court in Nash, Wilson, and Edgecombe County since 99. His potential trouble now is with the North Carolina Code of Judicial Conduct for managing a limited liability corporation he and his brother Roy created in 2012, along with two other LLCs. If the commission overseeing judicial conduct found such a violation, Pell Cooper could face formal discipline, including removal from the bench. The judge, reached by telephone, refused to speak with Carolina Journal about his role with one company, Will Clark Properties, LLC. So, you know, what you got here is a situation where, you know, Roy Cooper can't run the companies because that would be clearly be a conflict of interest with his brother now that he's governor. And so his brother is being listed as the manager of these properties, these businesses, which is against the law. So where will this lead? Will this get swept away and never heard from again? Let me suggest that won't happen with Don Carrington on the story.
No, probably not.
Don.
Probably not.
Don does not let things get swept away. It will be interesting, however, though, to see if any other media, i.e. News and Observer, WRAL, pick it up. It'll be interesting to see if they pick it up.
Mm-hmm.
You know how reluctant they were back in the Easley days to pick up any. They basically, the stories basically had to have become huge scandals before the News Observer would even come close to reporting it. 8:52. Let's check some sports headlines this morning. What you got, McGee?
All right, no Blue Marlins boated on the first day of the Big Rock Blue Marlin Tournament. Of the eight Dolphin brought to the scales, eye catchers, 41.1 pounder was the largest of the day. Day two underway now from Morehead City. Duke, as did ECU 2 years ago in the same location, against the same team, came within one win of the College World Series, but fell to Texas Tech 6-2. The 2018 Blue Devils set program records for wins in the season, both overall and in the ACC, while advancing to the first Super Regional in program history. Along with Texas Tech, three other Super Regional hosts advanced to Omaha, Texas, Arkansas, and Florida. Moving on, the 72nd Men's College World Series will take place June 16th through the 26th, 27th, if needed. And the 19-month-old daughter of U.S. Olympic skier Bodie Miller drowned in a Southern California swimming pool, according to authorities on Monday. It happened Sunday. Emily Miller died Sunday at an Orange County hospital the day after paramedics tried unsuccessfully to revive her after the drowning incident. I can't even begin to imagine.
That's awful.
That.
So sorry to hear that news.
Yep, very sad news.
You know, I saw a stat online last night. If Duke had made it to the College World Series, they were just like ECU. There were a couple of what did they lose to Texas?
6-2.
6-2. So they weren't. It wasn't quite as close.
Yeah, the score wasn't.
But if Duke had made it to the College World Series, the ECU record against teams in the World Series would have been 7-2.
Wow. Yeah.
That's pretty amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Because you had Washington in there. Carolina, Duke. Is there another one that made it? I don't think so.
No, that was it.
Anyway. Our sports update brought to you by the Tire Realty Group and Property Management Team. Always looking for new listings, and they will list your home to sell it or to lease it. In fact, they're the only firm that gives you a get-out-of-jail-free card. If you're not satisfied, you can fire them at any time. It's a one-day listing contract. When it comes to the Tire Realty Group, there's no penalty to cancel the listing agreement. But the big reason to list, the 99-day guarantee. If they don't sell it in 99 days, they will sell it for free at the Tire Realty Group. No upfront fees as well. And they will lease your home as well through Tire Property Management. They're leasing homes. And one other point, if you're looking for an opportunity to make a change in career sales. They're looking for new professionals right now at Tire Realty. Call them at 758-HOME or visit them online at 99orfree.com. We're going to do the laugh track again for you in a second, but let me remind you again that the big event on the Common tomorrow, the Town Common, 5 to 8. Gates will open at 5 o'clock. Band will start shortly after that. Get there and get yourself a good spot in your lounge chair and get ready to hear one of the best bands you've ever heard, the Eagles Tribute Band On the Border. Free concert tomorrow from 5 to 8. Brought to you by Suddenlink, Polly Pilon State Farm, Bojangles, Keller Williams Points East, Vidant Health, and Greenville Toyota. All right, let's redo the laugh track from this morning. Here's our laugh track replay, a classic cut from Rodney Dangerfield.
When I worked in this place and there was three acts in the bill besides myself, there was a girl singer who was the worst, you know. This girl singer was so bad. After her first song, the audience asked for a glass of water. Well, one night the boss told her to stop singing while the waiters were serving. She was terrible to look at, to an ugly girl, terrible to look at, you know? All night long, the audience kept yelling, up in front! Then the other act I worked with, was a rabies-infected dog act. And I didn't get along with these dogs at all, you know. Very bitter dogs, bitter dogs. I mean, they knocked around in show business for years. I couldn't get ahead. Very bitter dogs, you know, bitter dogs.
Bitter dogs.
Every night, I used to bark at my punchlines, you know.
What happened? That's it?
I remember one night, one of the dogs told me that Lassie was just lucky, you know, type of dogs. You know. Yeah, the dog told me Lassie got ahead, but not because of her talent, you know. Years ago, Rin-tin-tin, you know.
All right, that's it, everybody. Have a great Tuesday. We'll see you tomorrow.
This is the Pepsi that gets you stuff. Like tickets to...
Who doesn't love Pepsi stuff? Drink Pepsi, get stuff.
Let us help you find the right car or truck this spring here at East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Take advantage of May lease specials on all new Jeeps during the Jeep Celebration event. Lease the new 2019 Jeep Cherokee for only $199 a month. Lease the all-new 2018 Wrangler JL for just $239 a month. Or lease a new Jeep Grand Cherokee for only $269 a month.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't, so people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is the truck dealer in Eastern North Carolina. We are overloaded with new Ram trucks and we've discounted every one of them to move.
Folks from all over Eastern North Carolina are heading to Washington to save on new Ram trucks. Get up to $12,000 in total savings on select Ram 1500 trucks right now.
Visit us at WashingtonChrysler.com. Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. Drive a little to save a lot.
U.S. Cellular put towers where most others don't. So people can schedule a chiropractor visit out here. Or catch the game live way over here. Isn't that what you pay for? A stronger signal in the middle of anywhere.
Visit Real Wireless, your local U.S. Cellular authorized agent in Ahoskie, Williamston, and Windsor for the best deals in wireless and great service on a network that works in the middle of anywhere.
Hometown station.